Hi everyone, I'm any new province, and this week we're playing LazZoO Delver for Net Benefits, the series where we explore the benefits of net decking in Pauper. At first, when I saw LazZoO's top 8 deck from the Pauper challenge this weekend, I thought it was just another Scred Delver list. Man, was I ever wrong. This list gets rid of the Ninja of the Deep Bowers. Get out of here, Augurs of Bolas. We're jamming 4 copies of Brainstorm and Daze in this Delver list. What's more is that this deck runs a very sparse 12 creatures that we have to try to win the game with. I'll go over those creatures first. We'll start with Ghitu Lavarunner, a card I never would have expected to see in a Scred Delver list. It costs 1 red for a 1/2, and as long as there are 2 or more instant or sorcery cards in your graveyard, Ghitu Lavarunner gets +1/+0, and has haste. Like most Delver lists, we're going to spend the first couple of the turns of the game playing instants or sorceries and getting them in our graveyard so that as soon as Ghitu Lavarunner comes down, it gets in for a surprise 2 damage. Our other major threat is Delver of Secrets, a Pauper hallmark. It costs 1 blue for a 1/1, and at the beginning of your upkeep, you look at the top card of your library. You may reveal that card. If an instant or sorcery is revealed this way, transform Delver of Secrets. It transforms into Insectile Aberration, which is a 3/2 flyer. I really don't think this card needs any more introduction. I'm almost always on the wrong side of a few flip Delvers getting beat down for lethal as early as turn 5. Our last creature is one of the best 2-for-1s in the entire Pauper format. This is Spellstutter Sprite. It costs 1 and a blue for a 1/1 flash flyer, and when it enters the battlefield, counter target spell with converted mana cost X or less, where X is the number of fairies you control. LazZoO made the decision to chuck out those fairy miscreants alongside the ninjas and augurs, so Spellstutter Sprite is only ever powering itself up. Still, there's lots of 1, 2, and 3 drop cards in the Pauper format that we'd love to get a Spellstutter Sprite in the way of. Next, I'm going to talk about our card advantage and card filtering spells. This package is another cornerstone in the Delver archetype, and it starts out with what's probably the best card advantage spell in the format. That spell is Gush, which costs 4 and a blue, but instead of paying its mana cost, you can return 2 islands to your hand. That's super broken because this spell draws you 2 cards. Our next card filtering spells is one of the things that makes this build super interesting and also one of the most renowned card filtering spells in all of Magic's history. That spell is Brainstorm. It costs 1 blue for an instant and allows you to draw 3 cards and put 2 cards from your hand on top of your library in any order. There is a ton of stuff going on here. First of all, it's a little risky to play Brainstorm and Pauper at all because our fetch lands aren't very good. However, we're running a bunch of fetch lands to make sure Brainstorm is always as powerful as it can be. Also, having 4 of these ensures that we're going to flip our Delvers as early as possible so we can clock our opponent and protect our Delvers with counter magic. Next up is Ponder, which synergizes particularly well with Brainstorm. It costs 1 blue for a sorcery that lets you look at the top 3 cards of your library, then put them back in any order. You may shuffle your library, draw a card. This is another shuffle effect for our Brainstorm alongside the fetch lands that I'm going to be describing later. Also, Ponder is a great spell for setting up Delvers or digging for that counter magic or removal spell you need right away. Finally, we have Preordain, which is very simple but very strong. Preordain costs 1 blue for a sorcery and it lets you scry 2, then draw a card. Next up is our counter magic. This is another package that's been tuned by LazZoO to really stand out against other Is It Delver builds. It starts off with Daze, which costs 1 and a blue, but you can return an island you control to your hand rather than pay Daze's mana cost. It counters target spell unless its controller pays 1. Alongside Spellstutter Sprite, we're also running the OG counter spell, which costs blue and allows you to counter target spell, a catch-all answer for any spell your opponent might resolve that you really don't want them to. Our final piece of counter magic is another spell that you wouldn't typically find in the main board of Scred Delver decks. This is 2 copies of Dispel. It costs 1 blue for an instant that counters target instant spell. I'm used to seeing Dispel come in out of the sideboard in Is It Delver decks to protect you against decks like Is It Blitz or Mono Green Stompy. However, in this build, we're going to use Dispel to protect our sparse threat package. Finally, we have some spells to interact with our opponent's creatures if they manage to sneak through our counter magic or send damage straight to their face to end the game a little bit more quickly. That package starts with the most efficient piece of burn ever printed in Lightning Bolt. It costs 1 red and it deals 3 damage to any target. Because Lightning Bolt can't kill things like Mirror Enforcers or Gurmog Anglers, we're also running 3 copies of Scred. Scred deals damage to target creature equal to the number of snow permanents you control for 1 red mana at instant speed. Our last non-land card is Mutagenic Growth, which costs 1 green Phyrexian mana, but will always be paying 2 life for it. It gives target creature +2/+2 until end of turn. Mutagenic Growth can sometimes double as a counterspell for your opponent's first lightning bolt targeting something like your Delver or your Ghitu Lavarunner, but also it's a free spell to help lower the critical turn that you can turn your creature sideways and end the game. Alright, let's have a look at this mana base, starting off with our fetches that help our brainstorm. First, we've got Ash Barrens, which taps for colorless mana, but you can pay 1 and cycle it, which means discard it from your hand to search your library for a basic land card and then shuffle your library. We're also running 4 Evolving Wilds to bring us up to 7 fetches. You can tap and sacrifice Evolving Wilds to search your library for a basic land card, put it onto the battlefield tapped, then shuffle your library. I feel like playing with Evolving Wilds is going to be deceivingly complicated in this deck because you never know when you're going to have to leave it on the battlefield to get the full value out of a brainstorm. The last bit of our mana base is made up of snow basics to power up our screds. We have 9 snow-covered islands and 2 snow-covered basic mountains. We need these untapped so that we can cast our removal magic and our cantrips as early as possible. Alright, let's have a look at this sideboard, which is a little bit more in line with what you'd expect from a Scred Delver deck. It starts off with Annul for countering all of our opponent's artifact or enchantment spells. We have 2 Electrickeries as sweepers against X1 decks. We have an Echoing Truth for bouncing permanents we don't want to be on the battlefield. We have 2 Stormbound Geist for going up against opposing Delver decks or Edict decks. We have 2 Swirling Sandstorms as more efficient Wraths and Electrickeries that don't hit most of our creatures. And finally, we have 3 Pyroblasts and 3 Hydroblasts for going up against blue and red decks more effectively than the rest of our counter magic or removal. And there it is, LazZoO Delver by LazZoO. We're going to take this deck into a league at twitch.tv/anynewprovince. We're there every Monday night at 7 p.m. Atlantic time playing competitive Pauper decks. Before I go, I just want to remind you that you can like the video or subscribe to the channel down below. I'd seriously appreciate it. It's a great way to let me know you've enjoyed everything, and it really encourages me to keep making great Pauper content. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this deck tech, and hopefully I'll see you on Monday night.